Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to talk about how you can export individual objects from Cartoon Animator 4.5 to use in your external video editor projects. In the example shown in this video, we're going to use video production and editing software HitFilm. The scene you're looking at is composed of spotlight components as well as both foreground and background characters. A new feature with 4.5 is the ability to isolate objects so they will show up exclusively when clicked on. You'll find the Isolate Selection tool on the toolbar, and when it's enabled, you'll only see the objects in your scene that you select from the Scene Manager. We'll keep it disabled for now, and move on to the Render Settings panel to make sure everything is set for Transparent Video Export. In order to export the transparent video, we need to ensure that the MOV format is selected, and that the Transparent Video option is enabled. In the Object Sequence section below, you'll find an option to export into separate files. We want to ensure that this is also enabled in order to export all of the objects in our scene into separated videos with alpha data. From there, I'll select the 1080p resolution for export and make sure that we have range enabled to ensure that only the frames that are part of our project length are rendered. When you export using the Export into Separate Files option, it will prompt you to select a folder. So make sure you have one created to contain all of the files. There will be two subfolders once export is complete. The single image folder contains a single transparent background image, while the videos folder contains all of the transparent videos, one for each object in your scene. Okay, so now that we have all of our video files, it's time to import them into HitFilm. We'll start off by putting them all into a dedicated folder called Videos, just to organize things a bit better. After that's done, I'll create a new composite shot, and then drag all of those same videos in. We'll worry about the layer order in a moment, but first I'm going to import in both the background and foreground images into the timeline as well, and then adjust the clip length to correspond with the lengths of the other video clips. It's also important that I fit these images to the frame by right-clicking on the clips, and then selecting Fit to Frame under Transform. This will fit them to the same size as our viewport. What I want to do next is change the order of the track layers so that they are consistent with what we had in Cartoon Animator. You can simply click and drag the track layers around in the timeline to get the results that you want. Since each object that was in Cartoon Animator now has its own video layer in HitFilm, we can then manipulate them just like we would back in our original project. That means that you can click and drag each character around individually to change its position in your scene, and also adjust their visibility. Once you've tweaked the position of your characters, it's time to move on to the special effects that you can add in HitFilm. The first thing I'll do is add a blur effect to our spotlight layer to make them a bit softer. Once we have the layer selected, we can search for the blur effect from the effects panel and add it from there. You can also adjust the level of blur here as well. Next, we'll move on to adjust the color tone of the characters in the back to seem like they're being lit up differently from the foreground characters. I'll start by making the foreground characters invisible, and then starting with the one character in the back, I'll copy the same effects to the other characters later. First, I'll add a very slight blur to give a sort of a depth of field effect, as our foreground characters are going to be the main focus. After that, I'll search for the gamma effect, and apply that to our character layer, which allows us to tweak the RGB gamma values to something a bit more bluish that matches the spotlights above. Once we've found the level we like, we can then simply copy and paste these same effects to all of the other background layers by multi-selecting them, and then pasting the blur and gamma correct using Ctrl-V. After finishing that, I can then reveal the foreground characters again, and then repeat the same gamma effect process on the two characters to the side. This time I'll add a slightly weaker gamma effect to simulate a slight change in depth for those two characters from the main character in the middle. We can play back and see that things are looking pretty good so far, but let's add a couple of more things to emphasize the energy in our scene. I'm going to switch to editor mode first, and then drag in the composite shot 1 that we've been working on. We're going to apply a shake effect to the whole thing to simulate a high energy shaking dance floor. You're probably familiar with the process by now, the only difference this time is we're applying the effect to the entire composition instead of just a couple of select layers. The shake effect has a few different parameters that you can tweak based on the results that you want. Now for the finishing touches. I'm going to add a light flare in the back to really make our scene a bit more immersive. To do this, we'll start by adding a new plane in the Media tab. We'll need to make sure that we select the transparent background here before proceeding. From there, we can search for light flare under effects and add it to our empty plane. There are a few templates to choose from here, and once I've chosen one that I like, I'll play back to see the results. You'll notice that due to the shake effect of our main composition, that there is a mismatch of the movement with the light. This can easily be resolved by copy-pasting that shake effect from our main composition plane to the light flare plane. Once we've done that, I can add a bit more dramatic flare by setting intensity keys to the light at various intervals in our project to create a sort of a pulsing light effect. And there you have it. There's tons more cool effects that you can use in HitFilm to further enhance your project. But for now, I think this looks pretty decent. Make sure to check out our other Cartoon Animator 4.5 tutorials, as well as our forums at forum.reallusion.com, and I'll see you in the next video.